Thank you, Richa. First of all, I would like to congratulate you all. Am I audible? I congratulate to you and your team for organizing this workshop or FDP for 5 days on legal research methodology. And I am thankful to the dean, Faculty of Law, Professor C.P. Singh sir, as well as the ex-dean, Professor Rakesh Singh, and my colleague, Dr. Anurag Deep, who is also here, along with all the participants who are participating in this FDP on legal research methodology. Now, as the topic which you have chosen for this legal research methodology becomes very important in today's scenario. And you are going through this online or virtual FDP. This is the demand of the day. Due to this COVID-19, we are not able to meet physically, and that's why we are here virtually on this platform. So thank you for giving me this opportunity. And in this inaugural, I'm not going into detail as to what are the various methods, what is the research and everything, but I'll be touching some of the points which are required and which will be, I think, deliberated in the coming sessions which are there for the 5 days. And there are various things, as rightly told by Professor C.P. Singh, as to what is research. So when we talk about the research, then we have to look back the meaning of the research as to what is research. And what I found, it was somewhere in 1911, it is in the Oxford edition of the Encyclopedia Britannica. There, the research has been defined or meant as to go round in a circle. To go round in a circle, that is, you have to search again and again the thing which has been lost or which is missing in the earlier research. So research, as the word indicates, is a search again and again, or you have to search something which has already been searched by someone else, but that research has left certain parts, or that research has not extended to that we can say jurisdiction where you think that something has been lost, something has been missed. So you want to do something on that missing part, something on that part which has been left out by the earlier researcher. So you have to move round and round, so you have to move in a circle so that the research can be done. Now, because this is a topic on the legal research, so is there any difference between research and legal research? So when we talk about the legal research, then simply we see that one of the articles that has been published in 1982 in the Journal of Indian Law Institute by George D. Braden, that is legal research and some variations, etc. It was in 1982 Journal of Indian Law Institute. And there, what he tried to define as to legal research, he said that legal research is a study. A study of what? A study of a relationship between the word of the laws and the word of those who are purported to be governed by that research. That is, it's a relationship between the law and the persons, the law and the governance and the governed. That is the research that is called the legal research. Now, you see that in every legal research, one of the points is that we have to choose that what is the problem in the society, what is the law in existence, whether the law is fulfilling or controlling that crime or that offense or that particular thing by that law, is there any shortcoming in that law, how to propose, or if there is no law in existence, then we propose a model law for that. So this is how, this is a legal research, is a relationship between what? Between the law which is in existence or the governance and the governed who are purported to be governed by that law. So this is like that. And as we all know that the legal research, in legal research, our laboratory is not dependent upon the chemicals of like the science research. This is the laboratory, that is the society. Human beings are our research objects. They are the subjects. So on that basis, legal research is a relationship. Now, proceed further, if we start a research, then it is just like the construction of a house. as we start with the construction of the house, or we want that we must have our own home, and for that we started searching the land as to where is the land, and we purchased the land, we borrow some of the contractors, good contractors, the locality, and then we start having an architecture so that a design is to be made for the house. And then we start with coming up with some of the, that there should be a room, that the room number should be this, there should be a window, the size of the door would be like that. So all these things are there related to the construction of a house. Similarly, if we go through this research, then we find that this is somewhat similar to the construction of the house. So research methodology, that is having certain steps in that, and those steps starts from the very beginning, the selection and the formulation of the research problem. As to where is the problem, what is the problem on which we want to do research? Until and unless there is a problem, we cannot go for the research. If there is a problem, then only we'll proceed for the research. So selection and formulation of the research problem is the very first step on which one can move for doing the research. And in that formulation and selection of the problem, what we have to do, we have to come out with the literature review. Unless we are going for the literature as to what is the existing literature, whether there is any solution of the problem or not. So for that problem, we have to review the literature. And it is said that while reviewing the literature, we have to write once and we have to read thrice. So we have to making that review in writing, we have to read that literature 1, 2, 3 times so that we can understand as to what is written over there in that literature. And then we can review that. And this is the second stage of the research. So first, the selection and formulation of the problem, that is very important. If you have selected a good problem, then the outcome of that research would always be very, very good. And after that selection and formulation of problem, you have to review the literature. Then after reviewing the literature, you will come across with the hypothesis as to what is there in the existence and what you need to do. And this hypothetical situation, you will be coming only with this literature review. And what are the gaps? What are the missing points? What are the things which have been lost in the earlier research and the existing literature review? That is important. And by coming that, you have to create some hypothesis. And on that hypothesis, then you have to proceed on the methods as to what method you will adopt for your study. Because we all know that there are specifically two methods known, that is, one is the doctrinal method and other is the non-doctrinal method, or it is also known as the empirical method. And in that you can come with the qualitative research, quantitative research, then the case study method. So various methods are also there in which you can go through for the research, or these are the methods through which you can work on or proceed on your study. Then when you proceed for the study, then you will need certain designing, certain chapterization, certain work. So after that, you have to follow the preparation of the research design as to what are those things on which you have to proceed for your research work. So in that research designing preparation, you have to collect the data, you have to execute that data, you have to analyze that data. Because if it is going to be an empirical study, again you have to collect the data. There are various methods through which you can collect the data. There are various methods through which you can collect the data. At the same time, when you have collected the data, then you have to execute that and analyze that data as to what are the results which are coming up from that data collection. And in that data collection, then you will check, you will test your hypothesis. Whether that hypothesis is proving to be correct, whether that hypothesis is proving to be not or incorrect, this is up to that material which you have searched, that material, the data which you have collected, that data which you have executed, that data you have analyzed. So in that collection of the data, execution and analysis of that data, you have to decide as to regarding the testing of that hypothesis. Then you have to interpret that hypothesis. You have to interpret in terms of the testing of that hypothesis, and then you have to start the preparation for writing of the report. And preparation of the writing of report, that is into various parts. That research design, as I told you, in that chapter wise designing of that research problem, then you will put your material, you will put that reporting or writing of that report, that will come out from various aspects which you have collected through that data. And then with that writing of the report, you will also write the recommendations, the findings, and will reach to a conclusion as what has to be done, whether the existing law is sufficient, whether the execution of that law is sufficient to provide the controlling of that particular crime, offense, or whatever topic you have chosen. And if it is not there, then you can suggest some of the model law. If that is to be suggested by you, then you have to go for the entire law for that model practice. And then after finally concluding, you must also know that there are certain methods of the footnoting which are very, very important. So in India, we don't find that there is any universal or uniform method of footnoting. So everyone is deciding himself or herself or depending upon the supervisor as to what method of footnoting is to be there. So we have the APA model, we have the MLA model, we have the Chicago model, we have the Blue Book model, we have the, we can say this Oscola model. And in India, we find that the ILI method of footnoting is also there, but that is not of the universal application. So as a law teacher, we must go for that. There must be a universal, we can say, footnoting method through which that has to be there. Because every research publication or the authors or the publishers, they need that if they are going to publish the article, if they are going to publish a work of the person concerned or researcher, then they say that the footnoting method would be like this. So if you have prepared your work, following the ILI method, but the publisher is saying that you have to follow the MLA method, then you have to entirely go through your work and review that thing, and again you have to put this MLA method. So universality of the footnoting method is very, very much lacking here in India, for which we must work on that line, because ILI method is, I think, very good for the footnoting method. So footnoting is to be there, there are certain end notes, then references are to be there, bibliography is to be there, then annexes are also there. If there is any law existence, if there are policies, programs, government schemes, so which you have taken, then the bibliography must be very, very, we can say, rich, in the sense that you have consulted the work of all these things. But now what I'm witnessing through this internet or through this online things, that all the things are on the tips of the worker or the researcher. So we have to respect the ethical values also. And as Dr. Richa has asked me to speak on the ethics, which I will be giving on 10th of July, so only I will throw some light that ethical values are very, very important for a researcher. We should not rush for the last deadline to submit the work. And we got opportunity to work for 3 years, for 4 years. So we have to make the research in phase wise. And for that, we have to collect the material, we have to respect, we have to honor the privacy, dignity, equality, and various others, we can say, values, which are said to be the ethical values. And we have to follow that. So while concluding my talk, I would like to quote one of the observation which has been given by Clifford Moody. So I would like to quote that. I quote, "The research is defined as the process which includes defining and redefining problems, formulating hypotheses or suggested solutions, collecting, organizing, and evaluating data, making deductions, and reaching to conclusions. And at last, carefully testing the conclusions to determine whether they fit the formulating hypothesis or not," unquote. So I'm of the opinion that what Clifford Moody has written in 1927, that speaks everything about the research as to how the research problem has to be selected, data collection, hypothesis, generalization, research design, various methods of the research, conclusion, report writing, and all these are the process. And I suppose that in during 5 days period of this FDP, all these methods are to be discussed by various speakers. I have seen the name of those speakers there, and they will be discussing on all these materials, including the use of the library also, not only the library physically that is there, but also the online material also. So all these things are going to be very, very important for the participants, and I hope that they will enjoy the 5 days workshop of this FDP, organized by the Lucknow University Faculty of Law. And once again, I congratulate. And here I am electronically muting myself so that the other speakers may come. Thank you very much.